Assalamu alaikum, students. We have seen a couple of programs, basic programs, the development tools, how to create a program, what are the entry points of a program, and what are the other things that are associated. Today we are going to see what variables, data types, operators, and expressions are all about. The first thing that we must be able to know, there are character sets in C, which are some combination of letters, digits, special characters, white spaces, and all these things comprises a character set. Like an alpha case letter A to Z, a decimal from 0 to 9, some special characters like periods, semicolon, colon, question mark, minus plus, the bracket, the hash, number sign, and white space, space like blank space, horizontal space, new line, etc. These all particular things comprises a character set in this C or in any other language. There are some sequences as well which comprises of the things that how we can comprise these sequences. But when we talk about the thing, the smallest part that exists in C, we call that as a C token. C token is like int is a C token, float is a C token, a is a C token, plus is a C token, minus is a C token, curly braces, the smallest part that we can write is a C, we call that as a C token. Tokens, when we adjust the tokens in a sequence, which are right in their pattern, it forms a particular literal or a keyword or something else. It depends upon what we are going to form. But the smallest that part or a unit within your language or within this C is the token. There exist certain things we call as keywords and identifier. This is one of the most important thing you should able to comprehend within your mind. Every C is classified either every C word, जो भी हम C में लिखते हैं, is either classified in two categories. Either it's a keyword or it's an identifier. That means if I am going to write down a program will comprise of either the keywords or it will comprise of either the. Now there, when we talk about that, our program is going to be. So C keywords. That means C words, जो भी हम लिखते हैं, it is being either classified into keywords or it's being either classified into identifiers. Now, when the whole of the program that we have written are either the keywords or the identifiers, how we can identify? That means in order to write down the keywords, we call keywords, sometimes we call these as a reserved words, like print, printf, print, int, these are the reserved words which are being used to write down the programming language. However, aside from these reserved words, the other part, that is, for example, sum, some, my name, for example, Bilal, if I am going to write down, it will be treated as an identifier. Now, each and every particular thing has some rules to write down. The rules for write down your keyword has a fixed meaning. Like int is a fixed meaning. This means we are going to store, we are going to have an integer value, integer variable, which will store the data. Means the value, the meaning of that particular will not change. For example, I am writing down an example. I am taking an example. Like for example, num. I am taking a variable num. When we talk about int num, it says me that it's a variable by the name of num. Is it? It might contain a value of floating point number. It might contain a value of, say, integer value. It might contain a value of character. But when we talk about int only, int is a keyword. It has fixed meanings. That means it's an integer procedure. The int is meaning does not change, while at num meaning will change depending upon the situation. What it that means, it serves as a building block for the particular statement. like I am choosing int num, it says that num is a particular variable which is of type integer. That means it gives the basic definition, basic building block to that variable, and always it will be always written in the lower case. Now the keywords that are available within our C are 32, and there might be some. These are the keywords like auto, double, int, struct, break, else, long, and so on and so on. These words, we cannot use them in place of the variables. Say, for example, if I am going to write down like this, intauto, it will not be treated as a variable. It's a keyword which has a predefined meaning. Auto has predefined meaning, int has predefined meaning, return has predefined meaning, if has predefined, and all these, those are available within the list have predefined meaning. So these are called keywords. What are identifiers then? Identifiers refers to any names, the names of the variable, the functions, arrays, and so on. That means aside from the keywords, what comes? It comes the identifiers. And there are, again, I told you there are everywhere there are rules to write down each and everything. In order to write down the rules, in order to write down how you are going to write down your variables, functions, and arrays, the first character must be alphabet or underscore. It should not be anything, the first character of your, for example, num. The first character is n, it should be either alphabet or it should be either underscore. If we are going to write down like this, 1 num, it will not be treated as an identifier. It will show an error. The first character should always be an identifier, an alphabet or an underscore. It must consist of only letters, digits, or underscore. That means the dot or the dot sign, the full stop sign, is not being used to define the names of your identifiers, is it? Now the only there the your identifier will consist of either letters from A to Z, the digits from 0 to 9, or underscore, and only first 31 characters are significant, and this is about the range and cannot be used a keyword. That means we cannot use a keyword for in terms of our identifiers, and must not contain backspaces. We cannot write down like this, int, is it, Bilal, then space, then Maqbool. It should be combined, or if there should be underscore, there should be no white spaces between the two things if we are writing down the variable. Now when we talk about the third one, that means keywords, variables, and now the constants. Variables are rather which varies its value during the execution. But when we talk about the constants, constants in C refers to a fixed value and do not change during the execution of the type. For example, if I have written down n will be equivalent to 10, if I am writing down like this, const, const is the keyword which is used for making a variable constant, a particular value as a constant value. If I am going to write the const keyword in front of it, it becomes a constant. That means we are not allowed to change the value during the execution. This is what we there exist different kinds of the constant, like numeric constant, character constant, integer, real, single character constant, string constant, and we are going to see this particular thing again one by one. Now there integer constant, as I have spoken, real constant, there exist a lot of the constants available. And within the C or any other language within, we don't represent a real constant as that 2.03. It is represented as mantissa and exponent. The single character constant, backslash, and all those particular. There exist escape sequence as well. Escape sequence has a certain sequence which is having certain meaning. For example, if you are writing down backslash t, t is meant for horizontal tab. That means make a horizontal tab for we people in the output. Similarly, if I am writing down backslash a, it is audible alert, bell type sound. Backslash p, backspace, backslash n new line and so on. These are some, we call that as a escape sequences which are used within our code. And now variables. A data name used to store data value. Simple thing. That means where we can store our data, a container, a sort of a container where we can store our data. But this container will have no properties. Whether this data will store the integer data, whether this container will store the floating point data, or this data will store the character type data. And it may take different types of the data in terms of itself, depending upon the type for which it has been defined. The rules for writing down the variables are same as that of the identifier. It should not be a keyword. It should not contain void spaces. Upper cases, lower cases are allowed. Must begin with a letter or underscore. Normally should not be more than 8 characters. Normally, I'm not talking about strict thing. Normally, it should not be more than 8 characters. It is advisable to retain it up to 8 characters. So this is about the ruling. The rules for defining your variable is same as that of rules for defining your identifiers. What program is all about? When we talk about the program, we see that program transfers data from one to another. We take the input, read it, and make the output. Similarly, programming language, what it does, we write down the code, we store the data, execute it, process it, and based upon some programs written, we will get the output done. Is it? Now, when we talk about this particular thing, the data and all those particular things, there comes the concept of data types. As we have seen already, the data types which are available, we say that C is very rich in its data types, not very rich, but richer in data types. A variety of data types allow programmer to select appropriate data as per need. And when we talk about the classes of the data, there exist some books say there are 2 data types, some books say there are 3 data types. And one of the data types is a primary data type, derived data type, and user defined data. When we talk about the data types, primary data types, it's a character data type, integer, float, double, and void. When we talk about derived, which comes from the primitive data types, we say that it's an array, pointer, and function. When we talk about the user-defined data types, it's an enum, structure, and union. That means you have to keep in the mind that primitive data types are character, integer, float, double, and void. Derived are, which are being derived from the primary data types, that is array, pointers, and functions. And user-defined data that user can define of its own is the enum, structure, and these are some the basic statics about the data types. When we talk about this character, character is defined by the keyword char and it requires 1 byte of the memory. Its range is -128 to +120. Unsigned character is again of 1 byte, but its range is 0 to 255. Integer is of it is being defined as int. Sometimes, as you can see, basic definition, it says that it's of 2 bytes, but depending upon the compiler and so on and so on, you need to check this particular thing of your. Now today I'm going to stop here. Tomorrow inshallah we are going to have operators and expressions within our lecture. Hope that you have understood the things very well, and thank you for watching this video.